Hi guys, this is going to be the setup guide for getting your Samco guns working in for PlayStation and Sega Saturn. So we're going to run these through RetroArch. So the first thing you'll need to do is go to RetroArch. I'll leave a link down below where to get it from. So you just download it from there. Once that's downloaded, there's just a couple of extra things we need to do. We need to install some BIOS. So if we go here and go open file location from the shortcut it creates and scroll up to system, these are the files you'll need for your BIOS. I'm not going to give you links to these, but if you just do a quick search on the internet, I'm sure you'll be able to find them. So those first ones I selected were for PlayStation, and those second ones are for Sega Saturn. So once you have those dropped into your system folder, you'll just need to get some ROMs as well. Once again, I won't show you where to get these from, but a quick search will find them. Just search for PlayStation ROMs or Sega Saturn ROMs. I just put them straight in my C drive and make a little folder, and they should look something like this. So once you have your BIOSes and your ROMs, you're ready to go. For now, for the setup, we want to keep our guns unplugged. So when they're unplugged, we just need to open RetroArch. And then we just need to download our emulators. So we do that by going to Core Updater. And then we just scroll all the way down here to Sega Saturn. Keep going. There it is. And we're going to use Beetle Saturn. So just click on that and that'll install, and then we also want PlayStation. So with PlayStation, we want to use Beetle as well. There is PCSX HW. Unfortunately, that doesn't have mouse support at the moment. So we're just going to download the normal Beetle PSX, which works perfectly fine. So once we have both of those installed, we just need to go across to our drivers. And we just want to change this to RAW. I think it's set as DL or D input as default, but just make sure you change that to RAW. All right, once we've done that, we just need to set up our inputs. So if we scroll down here to input, scroll all the way down to user one binds, scroll down, and we just want to make sure while we're setting up that our mouse index is set to 0, and then we just scroll down to user one gun trigger. Yours will probably be blank, so all we have to do here is press enter and then hold the mouse trigger, and then we just go through and do the rest of those. So we do left mouse button is mouse 2, middle mouse button is mouse 3, and if you're running Sega Saturn, you'll need a gun start button as well. So I've just set mine to enter. Cool. Once we have that, if you're just using one gun, you're done. But if you want to do two guns, then we also have to set up our second bind. So the way we do that is we go to this. We just change our mouse index to 0 just for now. And then we go through and do that exact same setup again. So left trigger, etc. And then the only thing we have to do after that is change our mouse index back to 1. Alright, so once we've done all that, we've done all our initial setup, so we just need to exit out of RetroPie just by pressing escape. And now we can plug our guns in. So once we have both our guns plugged in, we go back into RetroArch. And now it's time to load a game. So let's go load content, go into C drive. This is where my games are saved. Yours might be saved somewhere else. And I'm going to use Point Blank as an example, just because it's a two-player game. And we make sure we're using the right emulator. So this is a PlayStation game, so we use the PlayStation emulator. And then our game will load, and then all we need to do is press F1, which will bring us to this menu here. And then we just scroll down to controls, and we just have to make sure that these controls are set to GunCon/GCon45. And then if you're using a second gun, you want that one as GunCon and GunCon G45 as well. Once you've done that, just restart your emulator. And this time we will have a cross here, usually in a pretty random position, but now that we've got this cross here, we can calibrate our guns as I showed in the build setup and introduction. So we just do that for both our guns. Now we just need to skip through a few screens here. And we will eventually get our normal calibration like you would on a normal PS1. So yeah, just like here. So we just need to calibrate our guns as we would on the original PS1 just by shooting the center of that screen and then pressing the A or B button when you're done. And there you have it, we're done. So you can see the blue dot is the player one gun, and then the pink dot is the player two gun. In a second here, I'll get both the guns shooting at the same time. There. So there you have it. Your two guns set up in PCSX Beetle. Very similar setup for Sega Saturn. I think the only bit is when you change the controls in the F1, when you press F1 when you load your core, it's called a Virtua Gun rather than a GunCon. But apart from that, exactly the same setup. So that's about it. I hope you like this video. As usual, I'm still working on doing heaps of other emulators. And the next one I think I'm going to do is PCSX2, which is the PlayStation 2 emulator. So if you don't want to miss out on that, make sure you subscribe. If you like this video, give it a like. Also, if you've just stumbled across this and you don't know what a Samco light gun is, check out my other videos. I have like total build guides on how to build your own Samco light gun and explanations and all that kind of stuff. And as usual, thanks for watching. Cheers.